everyone. If there is anyone joining from this part of the world, good morning. I know weekend is approaching. I'm going to not keep it very long. I'm going to give you some information about within York. York has been a great partner to Pyramid. We really value this partnership, and I'm very happy to be part of this webinar. So I would probably want to start by sharing some information about us as an institute. As I mentioned, I represent York, the School of Continuing Studies within New York. York is the third largest university in Canada. We've got two campuses in Toronto, our main campus, which is the Keele campus, and then we have a bilingual campus, which is the Glendon campus. Majority of the international students come down to our Keele campus. One of the highlights of the university is also the infrastructure prevalent, one of which being the subway station, which connects you to the entire GTA. I know these are unprecedented times. Everyone is trying to stay safe, and I urge you to stay indoors as much as you can. But I know it's not easy. As you move on and as things get better, you would obviously get an opportunity to come down to Canada and then explore our university as well. So in times when, you know, mobility will be more enhanced, the subway is a great way for any student to get connected to our institute, irrespective of where you are staying, whether you're staying close to the university or you might have some relatives in other parts of the city. Could be Brampton, could be Mississauga. It's a very easy commute. So I think for any international students, that is also very important to understand. In terms of our offerings, we offer programs both at an undergrad and postgrad level. But predominantly within the School of Continuing Studies, we offer postgrad certificate programs. And I'm happy to then take questions about these programs as we move on. But just to give you an overview, we've predominantly got programs in the area of business admin, human resource management, accounting at two levels, basic and advanced, public relations, digital content marketing. And for the first time this fall, we've introduced a program in backend and blockchain development as well. So whether you are looking to upskill yourself, whether you've got some work experience and you're looking at that next step professionally, or if you are a fresh graduate and you really want to enhance your skills, these are really good programs to look at. Within the school, we also offer English language pathway programs, both at an undergrad and to prepare you for a postgrad level. So if you don't have the desired English scores and you still want to come and study with us, there is absolutely a way where you can study a couple of months of English program with us, and that will prepare you well to get into both our undergrad or postgrad programs. So our programs are obviously developed by the industry experts. They are in sync with what the industry demands are. A couple of them also offer internship opportunities, not all of them, but there are a couple of them that offer you that opportunity. But as I mentioned, they are very much delivered and developed by industry experts. So they prepare you well for the times to come. As we speak, all our programs are being delivered online, but I've got good news in the way that, you know, even students that started with us in May are now able to come on campus. And this development is as recent as yesterday. Our quarantine plan got approved by Public Health Canada, which means we can absolutely welcome the students, obviously taking into account, you know, the expectations of IRCC. And also Public Health Canada. But these students that started with us in May, who could do 50% of their program online, will be able to now come to us over fall. And we're going to probably also maintain the same path for our incoming students over fall. So they will start the program online. They can study 4 months online till December. And then in January, we will look forward to welcoming them on campus as well. They will not be able to start on campus in the fall, but absolutely look to join us over winter. And I think that's a great development for those of you who might be interested to come and study with us at the School of Continuing Studies. So that gives you an overview about us as an institute. You know, I'm not going to talk a lot about what we have to offer. What I'll try and do is answer your specific queries as we move on in the webinar. It could be related to the program. It could be related to what the entry requirements are. It could be related to what sort of English proficiency is needed to get into these programs. And I'm going to now open the floor. And if there are any questions, Aman, I don't know how you want to do this. Do you want to unmute and they can ask, or they can type in whatever works best? I'm happy to go that
way. So for the introduction and information about the college, about the university, Dhruvji, and also the news that you shared about the quarantine plan and the students being allowed to travel is really amazing, and it will really motivate the students as well. So just to tell the students, all the students who are listening us, you can when I announce your name, you can unmute and you can speak to Dhruvji directly and ask about your queries. If in case you are facing any internet difficulty, you can also send your message privately to me with your contact number so that we can make speak to you as soon as possible. So just to start off, the first name I can see is Abhay. Abhay, can you hear us?
Yes, ma'am, I can hear. I'm currently pursuing my Bachelor of Arts degree and I'm in the final year. So I am looking at postgraduate diploma or courses options at York University.
All right. Abhay, thank you for sharing that information. If you've done a BA program, I don't know where the interest lies, because you typically, when you do BA, you specialize in an area. So I don't know what the specialization is or how you want to progress in terms of the programs that we have on offer. If you have some interest in business or HR, those are good options that you can look at. These are 8 month long programs, and we've got 3 intakes for these programs. Upcoming intake is in January. If you've completed your degree, you would need a 60% aggregate in your bachelor's, and you will need a IELTS score minimum of 6. But I would strongly recommend a 6.5 and above. So you know, for our programs, they get very, very competitive, and English proficiency is required of a higher standard. So I would strongly recommend that. So if you've got a 60% aggregate and you're able to meet the English proficiency requirements, then I will strongly recommend to look into the business or the HRM program, if that is something that you are interested in.
Sir, I have an overall 8 band in IELTS and I have an aggregate of 76% up till my 4th semester. Now, my university has not released the results of the 5th semester as of now.
And I believe you would need to do another semester, because if it's a 3-year degree, you would need to complete 6 semesters?
Yes, sir.
And when would you be finishing your degree?
Sir, I believe I would get the results by November or December.
If that is the case, then I would suggest you look at our summer intake, which would be May 2021.
Right, sir. But actually, many of the good courses are not available in summer intakes. They are only open in January and September.
Yeah. So as I said, for us, 3 main programs are open in May. And I think with your background, you should be able to pick between those 3. One is business, one is HR, one is accounting. I wouldn't recommend accounting given your background in BA. But the business and HR program, absolutely, you can look at.
Right, sir. And sir, there is one clause written in the admission requirements. It is that if you have completed a 3-year degree, then you need 1 year of work experience. So should I be looking at gaining work experience?
Not for the postgrad certificate programs.
Okay, right, sir. Sir, it is for Masters of Finance.
Yeah, so Masters programs are different. Feel free to look at the website to see what the prerequisites are.
Right, sir.
Each master's degree, it's going to be different.
Right, sir.
Okay. So next I have Amisha Joshi. Amisha, you can unmute and you can talk to Mr. Dhruv.
Hello, hi sir, hope you're doing well. Actually, I applied to York on 15 June, so I wanted to know the status of my application. Like, will I be even notified if I don't get through the same?
Which program have you applied for?
Sir, it was for Human Resources for January intake.
For the PG certificate?
Right, sir.
Yeah, so in a couple of weeks' time, we'll start assessing the applications. What's your profile if you are
I have done my BBA with CGPA 8.3 from IP University, and I have 2.5 years of experience in human resources in Delhi, and I've got 125 in Duolingo. I haven't given my IELTS, it's on this Monday.
Okay, great. It looks like a good profile. Aman, can you share her student ID with me?
Yes.
Yeah, and I did apply through Pyramid E service, like this consultancy.
Amisha, okay. Which branch of Pyramid are you connected with?
So either like Chandigarh or Delhi. There was this person, Simran, I've been connected with her.
So that's Delhi.
And that's why I'm asking for your student ID so that, you know, I can go in and have a look and then also internally talk to the team, given your credentials. So have you got work experience in the same domain?
Yes, sir. It's from human resources in an IT field, and I'm working in Delhi since 2.5 years, still working.
Okay, great. Okay, so please share your student ID. Aman, can you, if you can pass it on, then I'll have a chat internally.
Yes, sir. I'll make sure that I send it across. Don't worry.
Okay, great.
Thank you, sir.
No worries. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you, Amisha. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining in the session. So there is the student with the name of Solanki who's asking, is NIOS accepted by the university? And if yes, what would be the percentage requirement?
Yeah, so we will look at it on a case-to-case basis. I'm not going to outright say no, but we're going to look at the holistic profile. The academic requirements are the same. So, but that's an academic call. So the academics will decide on the same. I cannot make a general statement.
Right, absolutely, sir. Sir, moving ahead, there is a student with the name of Devishi. She is asking that she wants to go for the finance course and management, I believe accounting. And she's asking what academic percentage is required to attain scholarship?
So unfortunately, for the PG certificates, there are no scholarships on offer. Our scholarships are predominantly for undergrad programs, but the pricing is very competitive. If you look at our pricing, you could actually do two programs with a lesser cost when you compare it to a master's. And by doing two programs, you're also getting prolonged PGWP. So the return on investment is really good. Please be mindful of that.
Right, sir.
Sir, I have a related question with PGWP. Sir, if I do two courses, two postgraduate courses, then on Canada.cs website, it is mentioned that the length of PGWP will be the combined length of two courses. So in that case, will I get a 2 years work permit or 3 years work permit?
That's a good question. For any visa related questions, I would strongly recommend you connect with the Pyramid E services. Although it is 8 months, it's two academic sessions, right? That much I can share with you. So I think I answered the question around scholarships. The student wanted to know about undergrad. So with the undergrad programs, predominantly scholarships are for fall intake only. Those are very much defined on the website and are directly correlational to your academic score. So the higher the score, the better the chances of getting a scholarship. We also have faculty specific scholarships. So if you're applying to a particular faculty and you're able to get in, there's a default scholarship. But all those details you will be able to find on our website.
Sir, there's a student who's asking about her opportunity to study at York. She's having 6, not less than 5.5 in one module, and is already an MCOM. So would York University be accepting the student? The student name is Purva.
Yeah, so if you are able to meet the minimum academic requirements, yes, absolutely. With a 6 overall and one module 5.5, you will probably have to look at a 2 months of English program with us, which will be 2 months prior to starting the PG certificate program, and we will be able to provide you with a conditional offer. So you study with us 2 months, and then the moment you finish that, you get into the PG certificate. So for example, if you were to start the PG cert in January, you will come and study with us in November, study 2 months of English, and then you can transfer into the PG cert.
Okay, then adding on to this, Mr. Mohan, I just wanted to know that once we are doing this 2 month of course, they will be having some test, like we have to meet that capability.
Yeah. Okay. So like anywhere else in the world, you know, you are assessed on your capabilities, right?
Yeah. Okay.
But the good news is once you are done with it, you don't need to reset the IELTS or anything. Whatever you've gone through the program is good enough for you to get into the certificate.
Okay, that was my only question, that we have to reappear for the IELTS or not.
No, you don't.
Okay.
Sir, there's a student who has messaged in the chat box. The student is asking, the student name is Jitinder Singh. A very common question. If we got first approval and we don't get second approval, then is the fee refundable? And how much would be deducted, if in case any? And how much chances are there for AIP if the classes are from 10th of September? Sir, would you mind if I share this, the answer for the second section?
Yeah, let me do the first one, then you can share the answer for the second one, right? So our refund policy has been updated. It's clearly stated on our website. As per the recent update, you know, if you are in stage one and you end up starting our program, whatever course you have started, I'm not saying the program. So within the program, there are different subjects that you study. So if you are enrolled in suppose 2 subjects initially, that's the only fee that we will take. The rest would be refunded if the decision comes at that time. So if you are enrolled in the first subject and you already received a decision, then you're only enrolled in 1 subject and we will only be taking the fee for that subject, right? Rest everything would be refunded. But if you're enrolled in 2 subjects and you only get a decision by then, then unfortunately we'll have to keep the fee for those 2 subjects. So any subjects that you have started are non-refundable. Rest of the amount is refundable. And that's an update with our policy. We were not doing that before, but we know these are unprecedented times. So this is also basis the student-centric approach that we have taken.
Right. Thank you so much, sir. And there's a student with the name of Dalveer Kaur who has asked the same question, but there's a little bit, a difference in the question. So I'll repeat the question. So she's asking that she has applied in September 2020 in Human Resource Management Program. Mm-hmm. If in case she's unable to get the stage one visa and she's unable to start the classes, so how would the fee structure be impacted? Would the fee be refundable and would the whole amount be refunded?
So obviously, I would not recommend that you start the program without AIP, right?
Yeah.
If you're not able to do the same, then the logical step could be looking at a deferment to the next intake.
Right.
That is what I will suggest.
Perfect. And Jitinder, like you were asking about AIP. So let me just share with you that AIPs have started to come. And, you know, today itself, our organization had got 150 plus AIPs in one day. So stay positive, stay motivated, because, you know, the Canadian government and the Canadian embassies are working pretty hard to ensure that this, you know, stage one approvals are reaching out to the students who have applied. So stay connected if you have applied to Pyramid, and make sure that you keep on checking your personal email as well, which you have given ahead. Hopefully you will soon get an email about AIP. And if in case you have not applied yet, you can send your contact details in the private chat to me so that I can help you out further as well. Sir, moving to the next question, a gentleman with the name of Simar Bedi, he has done a bachelor's in engineering and then MBA as well. This person holds 16 years of experience in the management field. And he's asking if York would be able to, you know, accept his application based on GAP.
So, the School of Continuing Studies, as the name suggests, I think the answer lies in the name itself. We provide continued professional education. From an institutional perspective, we don't treat that as a gap. We treat that as experience. So, from an institutional perspective, I don't see a challenge. From a visa perspective, I would not be able to comment. So, I would strongly recommend, from an institutional perspective, absolutely, you could choose our business admin program and apply to the same if you see any merit in doing that program. But from a visa perspective, I would strongly recommend that you connect with the Pyramids team.
Right, right. Perfect. So, Simit, I hope you heard Mr. Dhruv out. And this is a request to all the students who are in the session. You know, to further support you and with all your queries that you have, you know, to process your application for the university, you can drop in your contact details to me so that I can have our, you know, counseling experts, the visa experts, call you back and take care of all your questions. If in case you're not comfortable sharing your contact details, I have just sent in my number as well. So you can call on that number and contact with us. Sir, moving ahead, there's a student with the name of Kuljeet Singh who wants to talk to you. Kuljeet, you can unmute and speak to Mr. Dhruv.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, I have applied Human Resource Management course in York University in September intake. Can I confirm after completing Human Resource Management course, I can get 1 year PGWP?
Yes, so the PGWP typically, and then again, I would strongly recommend you connect with Pyramid for further information, is equivalent to the duration of your program. So, for example, whatever the duration is, if it's an 8-month program, if it's a 1-year program, the PGWP is equivalent to the time you spend doing that program. So yes,
according to the duration of program, I will spend 8 months to complete this program. After completing 8 months, can I get 1 year PGWP according to the condition of PGWP?
I'm going to repeat myself. The PGWP is equivalent to the duration you spend studying your program, right? And I will strongly recommend, because this falls under the visa aspect, and as an representative of the institute, this is beyond the scope of my services, right? So I will strongly recommend connecting with the Aman and his team, but you will be able to get similar amount in terms of PGWP as the time you've spent studying your program. That much I can tell you.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Kuljeet. All right. Karan, I have just sent in my number. I hope
I got it. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you, Kuljeet. I got your number as well. Sir, I have a student with the name of Aslam Aziz who has sent a message in the chat box.
Yeah.
So, student saying, I have completed my graduation in BCom and I have 4 supplies and cleared it out as well. My IELTS score is 6.5, not less than 5.5 in one module. Can I get admission in PG program of business management at York? And he's also asking about the tenure. I think the kid joined the session late.
As part of the prerequisites, unfortunately, we can't look at more than one backlog. So with that, I'll probably have to say no to the profile.
Oh, okay. Right, sir. Aslam, I hope you got it. Because of your supplies, it would be tough to proceed with your application. But definitely, you can, you know, call us. We can help you out with, you know, better understanding on your profile. So if you can send me your contact details, in the chat section. I'll make sure that our visa counselor calls you back. And if you want to call me,
Amanji, he's our student. He's our student. Kochi brand student, not an issue.
Okay, ma'am. Please make sure that you connect this.
Sure.
Perfect. Thank you so much, ma'am. Sir, moving ahead, I would just refer to another question in the chat section. A student named Sukriti Anand has I'm a graduate in BSc Mathematics and I have a BA degree as well, having 4 years of teaching experience. Could you suggest me a course to build my profile better? I am comfortable with switching in the profession as well. So can you suggest something to the student?
I would then probably suggest between business admin or HR. And if she's comfortable speaking up, I'm happy to have a chat just to get an understanding of what she's done and
yeah.
What she's doing.
Sure. Yes. Good evening, sir. I'm there from India. Good morning to you. So I am basically having a profile in teaching and I'm teaching for the past 4 years, having a BSc degree in mathematics from Delhi University. And I have also completed my BEd, Bachelor's in Education. So I'm looking forward for some good course if in case it is there in your university. I am ready to switch from the teaching profile to any other if in case you have some better options.
Yeah, so I think with your background, maybe an HR could be a good option. The reason I say this is, someone in my family has had a similar path. So,
all right.
I can foresee that transition. Also, the fact being that tomorrow, then you can maybe, depending on what function of HR you're interested in, but you could also progress towards organizational behavior, right? So, that is what I would recommend if you're looking for a switch, given your background. So the HR program could be a good option for you.
All right. Thank you. Sir, could you just tell me, what will be the requirements for the same? Do I have to give the GMAT in that case? Or, will it be a long wait?
You don't have to give a GMAT. What's your aggregate like in your BEd or your BSc?
Yeah, my aggregate in BSc Mathematic Honours is 89%. And for BEd, it is 76%.
89% from Delhi University?
Yes.
I haven't ever heard that before in my life.
Yeah.
And I'm a graduate from the same university. So.
Oh God, the same course?
I wish. Maths is not my strong point, but I understand the marking scheme of Delhi University, having studied there.
I really worked hard. Yeah.
It is unrealistic, but kudos to you. And
thank you so much.
That's a fantastic profile to have. So, to be honest, you should be able to breeze through our admission process.
I'll be looking forward if you can just give me some highlights so that my procedure becomes easy to reach you out.
Yeah. So, what I'm going
basically,
to do
I'm looking for some graduate course. Yeah.
So, the PG certificate, I think, given your profile, would be a good way for you to start and get accustomed to the Canadian environment. And then what you could do is maybe add on a second program, again, based on what your area of interest is. So that you can identify as you start looking out for the first program. But as a first program, I would strongly recommend HR. So what I will do is start the process.
All right. So will ECA consider my BA degree? I understand.
Your scores are good enough, You don't need to bother.
All right.
Right. So, in the process, you can also connect with me.
Sure. So, for HR, I do not need a GMAT.
No, you don't. For our program, you don't.
Okay. Thank you.
Perfect. Sir, Vicky's question is, if he does 8+8 courses, that is both accounting and advanced accounting. So, will he get 3 years post-study work permit or 2 years post-study work permit?
Good question. I'll leave it up to your team to answer that.
No problem, sir. So Vicky, you can contact Pyramid E-Services team. If you have not spoken to anybody, you can call on the number that is shared below. We can talk about the visa prospect privately, about your profile and the query that you have raised. Sir, these are the questions that I have in the chat box. I'll just try to reiterate in the attendees list if anybody has any question to ask. Okay, so there's a question in the chat box. Arshdeep is asking, okay. Arshdeep, absolutely, online classes are compulsory. AIP aane ke baad, aapko online classes lagane hi padengi, beta. So the student is asking, after getting AIP, are online classes compulsory or not?
Yes, for fall, absolutely. Yeah, all our deliveries happening online for new students. But you will have an opportunity to come here January onward.
Right. So there's another query in the chat box. So somebody with the name of iPhone, dear, please share your actual name and your phone number as well with me.
So the answer to your question is yes. You will have to look at an ESL program. I understand your percentage, but we need higher English proficiency. So you will need to do 2 months of our ESL program. It will be a conditional offer. So you are already admitted into the program. So you don't need to worry about that.
Right. iPhone, can you, if you want, you can send your contact details to me so that we can, you know, further discuss about your case and help you out ahead. Okay, so Sukriti has again put in a question. She's asking what kind of scholarships could be served and if you can just guide me a little more about the course you suggested.
Good. So I can absolutely guide you. If possible, in fact, have a chat. It's very hard for me to write while I'm speaking.
No, that's completely fine.
And I can share this with you over email as well if you need. But given your background and you're looking for a switch, so a couple of things, and I've already spoken about this. So the thing is that the program is built in a way where the advisory committee is comprising of senior HR executives from many of Toronto's leading firms. And that has helped us craft a program and help you prepare better for things to come. When you become a human resource management professional, you know, firstly, our courses are approved by the HRPA, which is the Human Resource Professional Association, which means obviously it's a renowned program. And then as you move on, there are different certifications that you need. And through our program, then you're also helped to prepare well for those certifications. So for example, an entry level designation would require a CHRP, which is a certified human resource professional. And you can land up with, you know, job titles like an HR coordinator or an associate, and then you move on to a managerial level, which is a certified human resource leader, CHRL, and then finally the top management would fall under the CHRE. So that's how you will see yourself progressing. In terms of the courses that you will take, and whatever I'm stating is clearly defined on our website, you can absolutely go and check. But like I was talking about organizational behavior, given your previous experience and having acquired a BEd degree. So we've got a course in organizational behavior. We've got business communication for HR professional. We've got training and development. And these are all different aspects of within HR. So it gives you holistic knowledge of this function. In terms of scholarships, our programs, the tuition fee is very, very competitive. If you go and do your research, you'll find out it is very competitive even in terms of what the colleges are offering. And at the end of the day, you're getting an opportunity to do this at a university. So I think that's a fair comparison. If you do two programs, even the combined cost is much less than what you would shell out for a master, right? So I see return on investment right there. If there are any other questions related, okay, I'm happy to address.
Thank you. So then I'll just go to your website and just brief myself a bit, and then I'll get back to you in case it is required. Thank you so much.
All right, good luck.
Thank you so much, sir. There are a couple of questions in the chat box from the students. One of the student is Gurveen, who's asking, sir, I think you can read this as well, sir. Can you read the question?
Yeah.
So the student is looking for MBA at York. but I have reappeared and I have cleared it as well. So is there any possibility?
MBA at York is, I hate to compare, but think about it as getting into an IIM, so that you have an understanding of the process or in terms of how easy or difficult it is. The Schulich Business School is the number one business school in the country, so please be mindful of that. Having said that, please look at the prerequisites on our website. For the MBA program, you will have to apply online. So as a starting point, check the website to understand whether you will be able to fulfill the prerequisites or not.
Right. Gurveen, can you do me a favor? Can you please send your phone number to me? I would love to speak to you after the session and we can explore the website and we can, you know, talk about the information that you require for in-depth understanding for you. It would be really great if you can send your contact details. I'd love to speak to you.
So also to answer Vicky's question, I don't think you have to be fearful. As I mentioned before, we've got students who started in May online who are actually now coming in and taking our face-to-face classes in September. So if they are able to do it in fall, I don't think you'll have any problems doing it in January.
Right. Sir, there's a student with the name of Kuljeet who has put in a quick concern regarding the online classes and asking, is there a possibility for deferral?
Yeah, I think your office, if he's accepted the offer and paid the deposit, yeah, you can defer to Jan if the internet problems are, you know, not manageable.
Right. Perfect. Kuljeet, I hope you got the answer. If you have paid the fee, you have got the offer accepted and paid the fee, you do have an opportunity to defer. Please let us know if you're in touch with the team, like I believe you are. So please talk to the team and you can put across a deferral if it's really tough for you.
Sir, I had another query. Since I have not completed my degree yet and I am ineligible for January intake. So sir, should I do some online courses till that time? Does it improve my profile?
That's a personal choice. You know, any knowledge you acquire will enhance your capabilities. It's not a prerequisite, but it's absolutely up to you. If you want to do any related online program that will help you upskill yourself, go for it. But in terms of, you know, enhancing your profile, for us, it's not a prerequisite, right? So I would leave it entirely up to you.
Right, sir. And thank you.
Thank you so much for asking the question. So one last, you know, call to all the students and members from Pyramid E-Services. If you have any question, you can unmute and you can speak. I think that would be it, sir. I think everybody has got their queries answered.
Okay, no worries, Aman. Thank you for putting this together. Thank you to the entire Pyramid team. I was hoping that I would be able to see you all in person. That might have to wait, but can't thank you enough for all your support.
Thank you, sir.
And it is always a pleasure to connect. So have a great evening. And a great weekend ahead. And please stay safe, stay indoors as much as you can. And hopefully this will be behind us sooner than later.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Pyramid, visa for a better life.